final recital for the online trombone retreat of 2020, our favorite year on record. Just kidding. My name is Sebastian Vera, and with Brian Santero, Nick Schwartz, and Daniela Candelari, we're going to put on a short recital for you guys here in Michigan. So the first piece I'm going to play is a short piece by Robert Schumann called Wiedmung. It's originally written for voice and piano, and it's taken from a bigger song cycle from Myrten. And so he wrote this basically for dedicating it to his beloved wife Clara, and I would like to read the translation of the lyrics before I play it. It's one of the better love songs. So Wiedmung translates to dedication, and it translates to, "You my soul, you my heart, you my rapture, oh you my pain. You my world in which I live, my heaven you to which I aspire. Oh, you my grave into which my grief forever I've consigned. You are repose, you are peace, you are bestowed on me from heaven. Your love for me gives me my worth, your eyes transfigure me in mine. You raise me lovingly above myself, my guardian angel, my better self."
Thanks again for joining us. Again, that was Wiedmung by Schumann. This next piece is a classic for any trombonist starting to study solo rep and such. It's more so symphonique. Theoretically, there should be a title coming up around here sometime soon. But this is probably one of the first solos that any aspiring trombonist will study, and I find it's one of the most beautiful. It's one of the concert pieces by Alexandre Guimond. Can I get a B flat?
Mm-hmm.
something completely different.
All right. Hello, hello, hello. So the only thing that's staying the same now is we're going to play a French piece. But that's about it. So the piece we're playing, is Fantasy dans le style. How do you say it?
Dans le style.
I'm not a French speaker. The Richard Strauss by Fabien Gabelle. So I wish I could tell you more about this piece. I don't know a whole lot about it. I've tried. All I know about Fabien Gabelle is he's a conductor. Not much of a composer as far as what I can tell, but he's the conductor of l'Orchestre Symphonique de Quebec, Quebec City.
Is
he?
I thought so.
Could be.
Yeah, maybe.
Could play bassoon. There's no way of knowing. He has like no presence online, but he composed this piece for bass trombone. I don't know who it was written for. I don't know anything, but I really like the piece, and I've played it a couple times, and I'm going to play it again now. It's beautiful. It's in the style of Richard Strauss, if you couldn't tell from my gorgeous French. So it has a lot of the close harmonies of Strauss, but with kind of a French undertone, I would say. All right.
Thank you. Thank you.
so beautiful? Oh, man. Who'd have thunk? Who'd have thunk trombonists had access to this kind of beautiful music? I thought it was just bleeps and plops. So for the next next piece, my second piece, I'm doing the Andante et Allegro by Barat. This is a, I believe it was one of the, in the conservatoire aesthetic, they would always be writing concert pieces for each of the instruments, and this is one similar one. I believe Morceau Symphonique was in the same vein, where each year there would be a new trombone piece. And that's why we have so much great French music, because they would just pump out music for the new students. And honestly, when I heard this piece, this was about 15 years ago, I said, oh, trombone music can actually be beautiful. And I was just so struck by the complex harmonies and just beautiful music. I'll just shut up and play. How about that?
Do you need a beatbox?
Ah, I got a tuning slider.
Thank you.
So the next piece that I'm going to play, well, first of all, this is my last chance to thank everyone. All of our participants that hung out with us this week, it was really fun for us. We're used to having a much smaller focused group here live, and to have over 500 people register was incredible to us and blew us away. And we had a really wonderful time just getting to know a lot of different people and sharing a lot of information. definitely want to thank the John and Linda Hilt Foundation. Without that, none of this would be possible. Thank you to Daniela for putting up with us for this whole recital. All the families that help us, the Dakes, Sally Schwartz, for letting us take over their homes. So this piece is a song cycle by Defia. Daniela actually suggested this piece to me. I hadn't been aware of it before, and I've fallen in love with it. I really love it. It's seven short movements, and it was written around 1914, and they're just all Spanish folk songs, but highly expressive, and each has its own story that I won't go into, but I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so while Nick is getting ready to join me for the last piece, this is a piece that I wrote for him. It's called Extremely Close, and it's based on the book by Jonathan Safran Foer, Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close. It's a collection of, thank you. It's a collection of five songs from the entire book that spoke the strongest to me in a way. And I guess the thing to know is that I wanted to honor my love for songs as an art form and my love for Mahler and also my love for music of Ravel. So while I was writing this piece, I was working on an opera by Ravel, L'Enfant et le Sortilège, and it's the first example of prepared piano being used. So that's what we're doing in the third song, which is called Why I'm Not Where You Are. And it's supposed to have a sound of the record player having been played so often that the sound is not distinguished anymore. It's not distinguishable. Is that the right word? Yeah, anymore. And then leading into that is the leading into the fourth movement, obviously, it's called The Sixth Burrow. It's a story from the book about an island that floated away, island in Manhattan that floated away. And with that music, I wanted to honor a little bit of my heritage, which is from Serbia. And the last movement is the depiction of the falling man. So if you read the book, or if you saw the movie, or if you've seen the pictures that were around 9/11, there was that very, very famous picture of a man falling from the building. So the last movement is representing that. The last three notes on the bass trombone are supposed to be the heart rate stopping before the flat line at the end. And am I forgetting anything?
Mm-mm.
No, and this was written for Nick, so there we go.
Thank you.
guess thus ends the online, hopefully only online, or hopefully all, only all online trombone retreat. We had a great week. Come on, Brian. Come on, get on in here.
We're 6 feet apart. You can't tell by scale.
So we had a great week. It was interesting ending it this way, playing recital with barely any clapping, you know. Well, I guess it's like playing any other trombone recital then in that regard. But it was a really fun week, and we can't wait for next year, and hopefully we can put all this behind us, all this craziness in the world. But, we're going to go enjoy a drink on a Michigan porch now. And thank you, Sebastian and Brian and Allison and Taylor and Steve and my mom and the Dakes and the Hilts and Daniela and everyone. So thank you, and thank you for tuning in. And that's all I have to say.
Yeah. Should we say retreat yourself?
Oh, yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Retreat yourself.
Where's my drink?
Oh.